Kim, we'll send it back over to you.
All right, thank you so much, Margie. St. Louis firefighters Derek Martin and Rob Morrison, they died while fighting a fire in South St. Louis. That was in 2002. Now, both families work hard to this day to make sure that the city never forgets. Martin's family makes sure no one ever forgets the city's underserved children. So we are here right now with Wayman Brown, chairman of the Derek Martin Food Drive. We are also here with Fox 2 News 11 intern Kayla Martin, who I just found out 5 minutes ago was Derek Martin's daughter. I just cannot believe that you're his daughter. Before we get into the interview about what kind of items that you guys need for the toy drive, you guys have been putting on this toy drive now and the food drive for several years. It seems like your family is obviously very dedicated to maintaining his legacy of giving to the community.
Yes, it was very important to him. He started it and he tried to spearhead it, you know, just trying to feed families in the city around Christmas time, you know, and everyone's like choosing between toys or food. So he decided to help feed some families, and you know, we wanted to continue his legacy because he was really big on giving, gave his life, you know, so we want to do that in any way we can.
We also have Wayman Brown here, chairman of the Derek Martin Food Drive. This drive isn't until, and the giveaway isn't until December, but you guys are accepting donations right now, right?
Yes, we are. We're trying to collect as many donations, products, and also money as well, so we can get ahead of this and we can feed more families than we have before. So that's our goal, is to try to get this out to the public so they can come out and support us so we can help out a lot of people.
I know you guys are accepting monetary donations. What kind of food items do you guys need? Because I feel like sometimes when people say, hey, you know, we're taking a food donation, people just kind of clean out their pantries of things that they don't want.
Yeah.
That's a great question. We always are in need of canned goods, especially. That's reasonable, something people that can give very easily, but we want them to check the dates before they give them to us.
All right.
We need them at least last 3 months after they give.
Okay.
But we're looking for cereal, macaroni, mashed potatoes, noodles, different soups, even oats, peanut butter, jelly, things that have a long-lasting effects for a week at least. Our goal is to always try to feed as many families as we can during a stretch of at least a week during that holiday time.
Okay. Kayla, I imagine, I mean, you know, your family, you know, you guys are obviously very close-knit. You obviously have a big family here with the St. Louis Fire Department. But I know that that takes a lot of heavy lifting. I imagine you guys are also looking for volunteers too.
We are always looking for volunteers. Anyone that can come out and help that day of, the day before, like when we're getting all the bags together, that's when we really need our most volunteers.
Okay, and I guess, like, can kids help too? Because obviously you were a kid. I can imagine that you were kind of a voluntold when you were a kid too.
Yes, kids can definitely help. We reach out to several schools. We've been partnering with my school for about 5 years now. MICDS. but we're definitely looking to partner with more schools and some grocery stores so we can help pile in those donations.
Wayman, when you look at this young lady, you see that she's obviously picked up the baton and run with it. Anything that you would say to other young people who think, you know, oh, you know, they don't really need my help? What would you think?
I would say you're never too young to get involved.
Yeah.
What she's done is so remarkable. I'm so proud of her. And she's just a shining example of what can be done, especially with today's youth. You can do so many things if you just put that positive energy into something like this or something that you care about. And it just shows in her work ethic. And people are very appreciative. I know I am.
Well, I have to say, I mean, I've been working with her now for several weeks. Her work ethic is on point. Ladies and gentlemen, if you guys have anything that you want to donate to this effort, they are taking donations right now at the building that houses the Firefighters Institute for Racial Equality, or the Fire Building. The drive itself will be December 21st from 9 until 5. You can donate any time of the year at 1020 North Taylor. For more information, call 314-652-7107. You never know when you are in the presence of greatness here on the 9 a.m. show.